So the next speaker on the list is Moldova, His Excellency Minister Popescu. The floor is yours.
Madam Chair, dear colleagues, I would like to join the previous speakers in expressing gratitude to the Swedish OSCE chairpersonship, personally to Minister Ann Linde for organizing this ministerial council meeting in these challenging times. Madam Chair, it was here in Stockholm back in 1992 when the ministers participating at the third CSCE Ministerial Council committed to use the CSCE to consolidate human rights, democracy, the rule of law and economic freedom as the foundation for peace, security and stability, and to prevent, manage and solve conflicts. These commitments are among the core elements of the European security order. Regretfully, many of these commitments still need to be implemented. For the Republic of Moldova, that Council bears a special significance as it adopted the first ever consensual ministerial language referring to Moldova, stating in particular that a final political settlement of the conflict should be reached in order to establish durable peace in the region. While the situation in my country on the ground has been peaceful for almost three decades, little progress has been made towards fulfilling the objective set 29 years ago, achieving a final political settlement of the conflict in the Transnistrian region of the Republic of Moldova. We reaffirm the need to achieve a comprehensive, peaceful, and sustainable settlement of the Transnistrian conflict based on the sovereignty and territorial integrity of the Republic of Moldova within its internationally recognized borders with a special status for the Transnistrian region. We are glad that this goal will be reiterated in the OSCE ministerial statement on the negotiations in the 5+2 format. At the same time, efforts should continue towards resolving urgent issues and easing life of citizens residing in the region where possible. Here are some examples. The Moldovan authorities shared with the Transnistrian region more than 300 doses of anti-COVID-19 vaccines. Also, on the issue of transport, which is discussed in the negotiation process, we are glad that the number of residents from the region applying for neutral number plates has tripled. We remain committed to work on other issues related to the transport area in line with our international commitments and relevant legislation. However, as a general remark, many problems that the Transnistrian region is facing will only be resolved in the framework of a comprehensive political solution. Madam Chair, a special area of our concern is the further deterioration of the situation of human rights in the Transnistrian region. This issue was raised many times in the Permanent Council over the last years. The ongoing violation of human rights and fundamental freedoms in the region must stop. We also count on your active support and involvement in curbing the cases of political pressure on dissenting voices, illegal detentions and convictions, as well as in releasing political prisoners. The issue of ensuring appropriate conditions for the functioning of Latin script schools in the region should also be resolved. Dear colleagues, in December 1992, the Stockholm Ministerial Council adopted a decision that referred for the first time to the issue of Russian troops withdrawal from the Republic of Moldova. In particular, it envisaged the early, orderly, and complete withdrawal of foreign troops. Let me recall that the continued presence of a so-called operative group of Russian troops and stockpiles of munitions in Kobasna has no legal ground, is in contradiction with international commitments and the permanent neutrality status of the Republic of Moldova. In this context, we reiterate our readiness to engage in a constructive dialogue to follow up at a practical level on the initiative launched 2 years ago by the Russian Federation regarding the disposal of the non-transportable munitions. This process should be conducted in a transparent manner, and the OSCE could play a relevant role in accordance with its mandate. This would be an important step towards the resumption of the withdrawal of Russian troops, military equipment and ammunition from the territory of the Republic of Moldova in accordance with its long-standing commitments. We also need to keep on the agenda the issue of transformation of the current peacekeeping mechanism into a multinational civilian mission under international mandate. In conclusion, I would like to thank once again the Swedish chairpersonship for their efforts in 2021 and express our strong support for the incoming Polish chairpersonship. Thank you very much.